Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let me show you how to use Google Drive to build a questionnaire. So I'm sure just about everybody's run into the situation where they want to ask a lot of people certain questions. Either they want to take a survey or just ask people's opinions on something or plan a party. Well, you can do that pretty easily using the free Google Drive, formerly known as Google Docs service. Let me show you how. Now all I've done here is log on to my Google account, the same as your Gmail account if you use that, and go to drive.google.com. Now once you're there, you have all the documents that are part of your Google Drive. So you can have word processing documents, spreadsheets, etc. Let's create a new one by hitting the Create button here, and let's create it of type Form. So right away you can see here I've got a form that's already set up for me to ask questions. So let's create a sample one here. Let's call it Holiday Party, and we'll ask people's opinions on the company or school holiday party. And let's make the first question something like theme. And now here we get to have a question, also some help text, some extra text when they roll over the question. And we get to select the question type. So we're going to do a multiple choice question here. And we can do like holiday as the first option. Then just simply click to add an option there. Winter, maybe a New Year party. And then maybe we can add a other to it. So you add the typical thing where you can select other and enter your own answer. And then you can select whether or not this is a required question. They have to answer this. So let's hit done here. And now it automatically gives us a sample question two. So let's click in there and ask that. So let's ask what type of food. Let's also make this multiple choice and say pizza, sandwiches, buffet. Desserts only. And let's just make those the only options there. I can scroll up and hit done. Now to add more questions, you just go here to add item, and you can see you have all the different things you can do here. There's all sorts of cool stuff you can do, like adding a scale or a grid, choosing from a list, having checkboxes. Like we can do a checkbox here, and we can say like party options, allow each person to invite a guest. And this will simply be a checkbox here. We can add more checkboxes to the same thing. So you can add a whole different set of options. And then we could add paragraph text like, let me know your ideas, that type of thing. So a lot of cool different things that we can do here. We can even do, say, a scale. We can say, what should the budget for it be, and have it scale up and down. When you're done with this, you can do some other cool stuff. You can see here in the upper right, like for instance, we can add a theme. So let's go over here and add a theme, and it's going to give us some basic themes. Let's go and create this garden theme here. And now we can see there's fonts and colors associated with this. So let's apply that theme to it. We can also see there's more actions. We can see responses. We haven't even posted it yet. So we can click here at the bottom, and there's a link at the bottom there to the URL for this form. We can also hit email this form, and we see we can actually send it to a bunch of people. So you can send it to your company list. You can share it on Google+, and also you can embed it in a web page, so in your company or school website or your own personal website. And you can also edit the confirmation, what happens when it's over and the person has taken the survey, or whether or not they should see the results so far. In this case, that doesn't quite make sense. Hit the Save button there if you haven't recently saved the options. If we go back to Google Drive here, we can see that the holiday party is actually part of our Google Drive there now. So let's say we send this to people and they click on the link in their email, and this is what it looks like. So let's select some options here. Winter sandwiches, yes, and submit. And then you can see your response has been recorded. if we go to Google Drive here and we click on the holiday party, it's going to open up a spreadsheet. And in the spreadsheet you'll see all the results here with a timestamp even. So be able to quickly see all the results. And then if you're in here, and you can go to the form thing and you can actually edit form, which will allow you to go back in and edit the survey again. It's kind of tricky how to get back there, and that's how you do it. So it allows you to quickly be able to make a cool survey, cool questionnaire, send it to your friends, send it to your coworkers, schoolmates, or your website visitors, for instance, or even beta testers. I've used this for beta testing iOS games, for instance, and having people fill out a questionnaire afterwards, and then I can get all the results here. So some great things about this. First of all, of course, it's free. It's just part of Google's free services like Gmail. Second of all, it alleviates the whole thing of having to send out like emails to 30 people and then get 30 different responses and having to figure out, you know, tabulate the results. You get this all in a spreadsheet, so you can do it a lot easier, and you don't get all these emails back from people. You just simply go and check out the result in the spreadsheet, and you can print it out. You can export it from Google Docs or process it there. Use spreadsheet functions to run calculations. Like, for instance, if I had asked what the budget would be for the party, I could have simply calculated an average from that. So there are a lot of cool, useful things, tons of uses for this. And you saw how easy it was for me to actually create one of these. So you can just create one for almost any reason that you need a survey or quick questionnaire without having to worry about putting too much work into it. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.